Hello friends, welcome back to Channel NEET, and today we are going to continue with the chapter that is known as biological classification. Today is lecture number 6 and we are going to continue with the concept that is known as modern concept of classification. In the previous videos, we have covered about two kingdom classification, three kingdom classification and four kingdom classification. In this video, we are going to see in details about five kingdom classification. So let's start with five kingdom classification. First point, it was proposed by R. H. Whittaker, Taker, in year 1969. Second point, R. H. Whittaker was an American ecologist and taxonomist. Third point, this was a most recent and comprehensive system of classification. Fourth point, in this classification, eukaryotes were assigned four kingdoms, and prokaryotes were divided into one kingdom. So these two together are going to make up your five kingdom system of classification. So now just let's quickly see these points once again. It was proposed by R. H. Whittaker. This name is very much important in your 1969. Again, the year is very important. R. H. Whittaker was an American ecologist and taxonomist. This was one of the most comprehensive and detailed system of classification in this particular year. Okay, fine. According to this classification, we get eukaryotes, which are divided into four kingdom, and the prokaryotes, which are divided into one kingdom. Okay. Now we'll see of the basis of classification that was enlisted by R. H. Whittaker. Now let's see the fifth point. Basis of classification. So there were four important bases on which the classification was done. Okay, we'll just quickly try and understand the basis of classification. The first basis was complexity of the cell. Complexity of cell. So here R. H. Whittaker has taken two important aspects of the cell, whether the cell is prokaryotic or the cell is eukaryotic. So this was the first point that is very important. Second point to discuss is complexity of the body. Complexity of body. Here he has taken again two important factors, whether the cell is unicellular, cellular. The second important point is whether the cell is multicellular. So whether the cell is made up of one cell or whether the cell is made up of many cells, that was the complexity of the body, and that is the second point of basis of classification. The third important basis is mode of nutrition. Mode of nutrition. Okay, so this was the third very important aspect of his classification. Whether organism is autotrophic or heterotrophic. So this was again very important point with respect to the basis of classification. The fourth point that he considered is lifestyle of organism. What exactly is his lifestyle and what is his role in the ecological aspect? So this point becomes again very important. So here he has considered whether organism is producer, consumer or decomposer. Generally, you already know producers are plants, consumers could be animals which are dependent upon plant. Now decomposers is very important. You should remember decomposers are always fungi. Fine, just fix this point in your mind. Decomposers are generally fungi. So who are the decomposers? Fungi are the decomposers. Okay, so these are some important points on which the classification has been developed by R.H. Whittaker. So the four important point on which the classification was laid by R.H. Whittaker is, the first one is the complexity of the cell, next is the complexity of the body, next is mode of nutrition, and the lifestyle of an organism, what is his ecological role. Okay, so these are the four important points on which the basis of classification was done by R.H. Whittaker. So each word he took into consideration while classification or giving a proper placing to an organism. Fine. So in the complexity of the cell, he has taken prokaryotic or eukaryotic. In the complexity of the body, whether the cell is having unicellular or multicellular. In mode of nutrition, he has considered whether an organism is heterotrophic, okay, or autotrophic. Fine. In lifestyle, he has seen whether it is a producer, it is a consumer, or it is an decomposer. Okay, fine. On basis of this classification, what he has observed, he has divided organisms in five kingdom classification. Now we'll see some merits of this classification. Now let us discuss the next point, that are the merit of five kingdom classification. What could be the merit of the classification? First point, all organisms have been given proper taxonomic position, means the classification was up to the mark. Okay, fine. We can justify that. Let's see how. Next point. It has given better relationship with respect to two major important aspects: level of organization and mode of nutrition. So these are the two important aspects where you could see a better relationship between level of organization. What is level of organization? From the cells, from tissues, organ system, that is nothing but a level of organization. And mode of nutrition, again, it is very important with respect to what we called across, whether the particular organism is autotrophic or heterotrophic. Next and very important point, Euglena was classified under Protista. Next point, logically and physiologically different organism were classified like cyanobacteria and bacteria were kept in kingdom Monera. So these are some merit what we could see in the classification that was given by R.H. Whittaker. First, all organisms were properly classified and the proper taxonomic position was given to the organism. It has helped us to give a proper and better relationship with respect to level of organization and also with respect to the mode of nutrition. Okay, Euglena was one of the special organism that we could see, and it has been classified under Protista. This could be very important MCQs. Okay, fine. And morphologically and the physiologically, different organism like cyanobacteria, okay, and bacteria were placed in kingdom Monera. So these are some important aspects of five kingdom classification given by R.H. Whittaker. Now we will see some demerits of classification that has been done by R.H. Whittaker. Now let us see some demerits that we could see in five kingdom system of classification. First demerit: this system of classification could not classify very important organism viruses. So they actually could not give a proper place in the classification system for the viruses. So this becomes very important demerit of R.H. Whittaker system of classification. Second, Protista is a group of diverse organism, means many organisms are there, ऑर्गेनिज्म विथ डिफरेंट डायरेक्शन ऑफ इवोल्यूशन इन हायर फॉर्म्स. द थ्री हायर किंगडम वर पॉलीफाइलेटिक, मीन्स देर वर डिफरेंट इवोल्यूशनरी एस्पेक्ट. Now let us see what are the demerits. Once again, the first important demerit is they could not classify viruses. Second important aspect, that protista are being very diverse group, means there are many organism in that particular group, and from this organism you can see different type of evolution. Okay, you can see many different type of evolution, okay, in the higher forms. Okay, so there were different directions. For example, if this is a common ancestor, you get the developmental pattern here, you get developmental pattern here, and you get developmental pattern here. So these are three different direction of evolution that has been developed from protista. Okay, fine. Therefore the word polyphyletic. Okay, now let us see which are the kingdoms finally we got as when we classified the organism in this five kingdom classification. Okay, so now let's name those five kingdoms what we have got after R.H. Whittaker's classification. So five kingdoms are we got Monera the first, next was Protista, the third was Plantae, the fourth was Fungi, and the last was Animalia. So these are the five kingdoms what we have got after when R.H. Whittaker has given us the classification. So here we complete five kingdom classification that was given by R.H. Whittaker in details. Okay, hope you like today's video. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.